So I guess I'll try to minimalize this. I didn't want to speak of it, but because I feel like the candy after, and you're like, oh, I can't have a sweet now. I've already had it. But when you have this shock effect in the news, you know, the shock effect of the preventative blossoming take, I'm like, oh, this is awful. This is awful, and we're all thinking this is incredibly awful. And so, oddly, as her repartee of indulgent famic moments right there, she is taking the doctors and their medicine, and pretty much I think many men will majority there and go, that's ridiculous and superiorly insane. To have that procedure going on, it'd be better for the woman to just live her life out without ever walking into there. So, perhaps she is a major event in the moment to change, to just be a natural death, normal. And so let that happen, and that will be beautiful. So good for her if that is the outcome of it, because the other this preventative. Oh my gosh, the preventative. You might as well just excuse me, my finger hurts, cut it off. All right, so all women, we have to start using our bosoms here and owning them, and stop the shallowing self. And yeah, I do walk with it, I know, and yeah, so here. Have to bring them up horribly, like the overall effect of what do you call them? Those things. Yeah. But yeah, bring these arms higher in there, and I think that there's a lot of Miss Proud represents. And I'm not talking Nurse Ratched style, but oh my gosh. When it keeps sinking and sinking and sinking and saying that this is going to be you, it's going to be you, it's going to be you, because it's only been heard, and I'm like, well, perhaps I have been a major a denigrant and not helping, because I have just been in the shire coward zonation of, oh my gosh, the meagers of the wifedom. And when you're in there, you know, feel it, you know. You feel it? You feel the compression? It just sinks, all of this. So none of the lymph, none of this freedom in this breath area. We are just smashing ourselves into this meager of the relationship with the male. You know what I'm saying? And that could even be the male from the outside. It comes in the postal. It can be this male for sure. I didn't get what I wanted in the mail. So yeah, oh my goodness. And then, so there, this moment in the body, in the upper chest area, you feel it. If you just push it extra hard in the reaction of the exaggeration, and you feel the tensions of the tissues smash and smoosh and smash and smoosh and smash and smoosh upon each other. And when they're smashing and smooshing upon each other, It is an odd oozant moment that is not good. It's an overheating, isn't it? It feels as an overheating, a wrong overheating. Not a workout overheating, because in the workout, we're up, we're pulled up. And yes, and I know this. I know there's a woman's there who've been the dancer for many years, and they have also received the from the ugliest. But what can I say? And My particular slant on it, if you want to go there, is that we are missing here. We're living in the compression. You know, that type of feeling, as if you oversmoked. So there. So oddly. It is a wake up for that. Gosh dang, I look fatso today, and I'm a, what do you call it, a fat indulgent, aren't I? In it speak. Oh my gosh, what does that do to me? It's just like rains on top of me every day, doesn't it? like it's a, it takes a part of my body and just another throw at my own spearing, you know. So there's the word spearing, thoughts, not gathering, and then that attractive haton. So there's the haton throughput, which is there's the physical causality event of the posture, and then there's the other. Then there's the I didn't succeed moment in the brain. And so in the brain, when you have these little non-succeed moments, oh my gosh, I look like the Dr. Ruth now. Oh my gosh, that's terrible. Am I really this old? Probably looking like the Dr. Ruth. It's awful. I'm not the Dr. Ruth, I swear. It's a funny voice, though. Funny voice today. Where's the mono? How do you call it? Of the black and white here. What was I gonna say then? I'm utterly giggling because with the shock event, like I said, it could be absolutely expounded and stop. It can stop the horrible practice everywhere. So let her come out maybe next week, and it will be a false. That will be wonderful. Like a false event, like a false alarm, like she really didn't do it, you know. We're all hoping that one, aren't we? She really didn't do it, you know. She didn't. I'm talking about Mr. Jolie there in the news. Good heavens. Well, what can I say? If it happens, it happens. We have our own particular futures, and how come there are the walkers, the walking people, who go to the doctor and believe it? I'm not. I can't change them. I can't change them. Can I change them? No. I'm like, do I want to change them in a way? And it's like. Well, yes, I want to change that habit of them, obviously, there. But then there is that group, and it's like a control. If I have the power to control that group, oh my gosh, maybe I'll keep that power and just change what they're doing with it. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Look at me, I'm doing it, aren't I? Smashing on the smoosh. And isn't it all how one thing is like flowing into the other? There is that guy who does call himself, he was a smoosh. And maybe there is already a sign that he was a healant in the typical, the word of his username. He's already offering a smoosh answer into something. Not to. I have a waist there, see? Oh my gosh. Oh, she's not Alex. Say it. Oh, I had a terrible outfit this morning. An outfit meaning not something you wear, but you do wear it. A throw at like an aggression, you know, an in-house aggression fight with my brothers, my three brothers there, and it is the funniest one. And then I find out the one. I have one brother in particular that it is a fume out. A fume out on a periculum, I'll call it, but the per diem moment of he would have already ordered a straight jacket for me, but at this point he would even be choosing the colors, choosing them in different colors. And so there, I'm asking, okay, in this moment when I'm feeling non-sane and I'm just in the house talking to myself or having a little poet outburst, and they had like these microphones, and they listen to persons in the house. And I'm like, oh my gosh, they're listening to persons in the house. You know, I can be like put on tape or something and just whisked off and have to wear a paisley straitjacket because my brother, who supports, you know, economy, normalia style, would have already written that one in. Woman talks to herself. And I'm like, how do I end up with it? You know, how do I end up with the brothers like this? You know, they're so standard, so standard. And then so I fight back and I'm saying, okay, there's the green piece. And then what's the other version? You are either the green piece or you are loading the nukes. There are only the two versions, aren't there? It's like, pick a side. No, really. Which side are you on? So, posture, free, and breathe also. Not a strong stark in it, but a breath in it also. And I imagine looking at the muscle men at this moment are good also for the way they posture and pose. And breathe, and you'll probably find the ones who win the super shows are the ones who breathe in their movements also. Yeah. Oh my gosh, and there's one woman I saw her, and she's the I don't know her descent of anything, but she's beautiful and but in another way. And then there's a woman in the audience crying because she sees her body like this, the muscle woman. And there's a woman in the audience is crying. She's crying because she sees, like, I think her name is Vanessa Morris or something like this. But, oh my gosh, she's beautiful in her way. Beautiful. Wow. I know, I was shock effect. I need to talk of the shock effect. I was rushed out. I was rushed out from it, and I immediately, like, okay, shock effect. I was thinking about this like for 2 or 3 days. You know, I hear this event off the Yahoo, and I'm like, oh my gosh. Well, aside from all, I start thinking, am I a shock effect person? I have to have a shock effect. And what does a shock effect event mean when the person is there? When the person is there, you know, I have to deliver mine and she has to deliver hers and this one over there. And so it becomes like this role of shock effect, you know. And do we, when we're all releasing our shock effects, do we make it? Do you know, do we actually make that earth rumble and become an earthquake? Do we make the planet shake? Come on. And so with that, if we are capable of causing it right here in the matter of our events, our shock events all around the world, that is a power, major power. And that's a major power they don't want us to have. They find the person to have this major power, be anything. And think of the things already that it is. It's Christmas. Think of that. You just say, it's Christmas. And think of all of the things that just start flowing in the major power in the heads, you know? They're just having it. Oh my gosh, shopping is just there. It has to be. So yeah, so when we're thinking of it, is a shock effect. Oh yes. So I was like, all I have to pull out of my rabbit hat, and I'm losing my shock effect things. There's nothing left. I'm pulling out of my rabbit hat that my mother took the LSD when she was pregnant with me as the baby back in the 60s. And that's all I have. I don't have anything else. And I'm not sure how much. I don't know how much. But she told this to the iridologist woman in the office with me, and as a disclosure, she just had to tell. She wasn't happy with the telling, but she felt it's there now. She has to say it. So, So I'm flower power child plus LSD. Forever. Forever. Yeah, that's a bit of shock effect, isn't it?